It's a fact no one disputes. Alabama is about to execute 44-year-old Nathaniel Woods for the murders of three police officers he did not kill. June 17, 2004. Three Birmingham police officers are gunned down attempting to serve a misdemeanor warrant on Woods at a home in the city's west side. Woods had surrendered to police when another man in the house, Kerry Spencer, opened fire with an assault rifle, killing officers Charles Bennett, Carlos Owen, and Harley Chisholm.
Never in my life have I ever imagined going to three funerals in 2 days and feeling the pain and hurt that we've all experienced.
The shocking murders left a city grieving. Spencer confessed to the shootings and said soon after his arrest that he had acted alone. He was convicted of the murders and sits on Alabama's death row. But for prosecutors, one conviction wasn't enough. They charged Woods with three counts of capital murder, accusing him of conspiring or being complicit in the killing of the officers.
In order for a person to be convicted on complicity, they have to be involved in a plan or a scheme to kill.
Prosecutors alleged a calculating Woods intentionally lured the officers into the home where Spencer was waiting.
Absolutely not. He was terrified when they came into the house.
Woods was found guilty. And even though he hadn't fired a single shot, he was sentenced to death.
He thought it was the craziest thing in the world. He's like, how? How? Because, you know, I mean, he didn't do anything wrong.
How much do you think race played a role in this case?
I think it did play a role. I mean, I think that if you look at the victims, it's three white officers. And if you look at the people who are sitting on death row, it's two black men.
Woods' current defense team says his conviction was just one of many legal wrongs, including years of bungled appeals by other attorneys. Now down to his final hours, Woods' family believes their only hope is for the public to convince Alabama's governor that killing a man who killed no one is wrong.
I love my brother. People need to know about this.
We wanted to know what the families of the murdered police officers thought of Woods. We reached two of them who said they either couldn't or wouldn't talk to us. But in a local radio interview last year, the granddaughter of Officer Carlos Owen reflected on his loss and the hole it's left in all their lives.
I remember how special he used to make each of his grandkids feel. That was something that he was so good at, making others feel loved and special.
What would you say to the families of the officers who died?
We are deeply, deeply sorry for what happened that day. But the murderer of their family members is sitting on death row. He has confessed. He is being punished. They don't need an innocent man's blood as well.
Martin, you actually spoke with Kerry Spencer tonight. What's he saying?
He was calling from death row, the same death row, of course, on which Nathaniel Woods is spending his last few hours. You know, it's hard to imagine the man who has confessed to killing three police officers would have a guilty conscience, but it appears he does. But in this case, it's guilt over what he believes is wrong, that Nathaniel Woods in no way had anything to do with the deaths of those officers. Here's some of our conversation.
You are saying that you are totally responsible for the murders of those police officers.
And that one that shot everybody that day.
And Nathaniel Woods is completely innocent, you say?
Absolutely. He didn't know I was going to shoot anybody. I mean, I put this on my life, on my children's life. I mean, like, I swear to God, I didn't know I was going to do this. So how would Nate know? I mean, this was some spur of the moment decision. You know what I mean? We had no time to think about what the was going to happen that day.
This was not a plan. You didn't conspire together.
No, no, man. That's just something they put out there. You see, it was no warrant or nothing. They just made up a story for a jury to believe to convict both of us.
Wow.
And again, that's Kerry Spencer saying that Woods is totally innocent, that this was a spur of the moment, and that Spencer takes full responsibility for what happened. Alabama, he says, is executing the wrong person.
Wow. And nothing, there's nothing... Nothing anyone can do, Martin? Nothing.
The governor could intervene. That's what everyone is hoping for. There could be some sort of stay. There could even be just a temporary stay to allow a more formal investigation and look at this point. There are a number of other court actions, but right now all eyes are focused on the governor here in Montgomery.
Wow. Martin Savage. Keep us updated. Thank you.